Hello everyone, in the present video I am going to give you an idea about very important topic named early mobilization in intensive care unit. Now the outline of this topic is what is early mobilization in ICU, why early mobilization in ICU is important, third, what are the benefits of early mobilization in ICU, fourth, what if there is no early mobilization, and fifth, what are the important points of concern. Now first, we need to understand the early mobilization in ICU is safe, feasible, and it leads to positive results in outcome and recovery. Now let us see all the points in detail. What is early mobilization? So early mobilization refers to the activity that are carried out from the initial physiological stabilization and that can be continued during the stay of the patient in ICU. So to make the patient turn, sit, stand, walk around the bed within the ICU, and systematically we are decreasing the base of support. Now why the early mobilization is very important? Because it minimizes the complication of bed rest like breakdown of skin, pressure sores, DVT, deep vein thrombosis, strength and endurance of muscle. Along with that, it improves the patient's overall function, promotes the ventilator weaning in timely manner, and it decreases the ICU and hospital length of stay, which in turn leads to decrease in the hospital cost, and that's why it is very important. Now let us see what are the benefits of early mobilization in ICU. Now walking will basically promote the blood flow of oxygen throughout the body. It improves the blood flow, and this improved blood flow will aid in the quicker wound healing. And by walking, gastrointestinal, genitourinary, pulmonary and urinary tract functions will be improved. Walking will increase the muscle tone and strength, and ambulation will be helpful to improve coordination, posture and balance. And early ambulation, it helps to improve the appetite after the surgery, and walking improves the patient's feeling of independence, their mood and their self-esteem. Now the question arises, if there is no early ambulation, what will happen? So 4 points you can see: pressure sore, bone weakness, constipation and likely to develop DVT. Let us try to understand. Pressure ulcers are very much common after the patients are stationary after a long period of time. So if we are doing the early mobilization, it can be avoided. When a person's bone do not bear the weight, they lose the minerals which leads to the weakness of the bone. So that can be avoided. Third, walking post-surgery decreases the constipation. So if there is no early ambulation, the chances of constipation may increase. And non-walking patients are more likely to develop venous stasis and DVT. So it is very important to do the early mobilization. Now let us see the important points of concern. As technology and medications have improved and increased, the survival rates are also increasing in intensive care unit. So it is important to focus on improving the patient's outcomes and recovery. Now another important point, that is, critically ill patients have limited activity because of three main factors. First is diagnosis, second is equipment, and third is the condition with which they are suffering. And as a result of limited activity, they can suffer from three main things, that is deconditioning, muscle weakness and infection. So we have to consider this point before giving the treatment. Now the early mobilization of the patient in the ICU has received considerable attention in clinical and scientific literature over the past several years. Now many research have been done into this area to find out the effects of early mobilization on multiple factors like patient safety, ambulation capacity, muscle strength, functional outcomes such as activity of daily living, duration of mechanical ventilation, ICU length of stay and mortality. Apart from this, there are many studies have done, and they have shown that the survivors of critical illness have impaired exercise capacity and persistent weakness, suboptimal quality of life, and also the high cost of healthcare utilization. So ICU-based interventions, it plays a very good role in reducing the ongoing physical and neuropsychological impairment in ICU survivals in both short and long terms. But working in the ICU is not that easy. It's a difficult environment in which to mobilize the critically ill patient because of multiple life-sustaining catheters and monitors, sedative medications, impaired level of alertness from medications and sleep disturbances, electrolyte imbalances like your sodium, potassium and chloride, alteration in the normal level, altered hemodynamic status will be contributing factor that will limit the mobilization in the ICU. So there are many points to consider before we treat the patient in ICU. I wish this video will be helpful to you all. And I would like to quote this: most of us are reaping the fruits of the tree which has been planted by our seniors. So thank you very much for watching this video. Thank you.